her mother.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Joe takes on one mean mama.
Ain't my problem.
Mm-mm. You don't even know me. A mother's sense of entitlement wreaks havoc on her daughter's pocketbook. Customer service rep Ebony Kearney is suing her mother for past due rent. Defendant Kimberly Cobb says the plaintiff should pay because she is her daughter. Now it's Joe time.
Ms. Kearney, you are suing your mother, Ms. Cobb, and your allegations are that she could not get her own apartment approved because of her credit problems, so you signed the lease for her.
Yes, that is correct.
You say she deliberately stopped paying the rent and stopped paying on the utility bill that you had also taken out for her in your name.
Yes, that's
leading
not true.
To an eviction proceeding, which she did not tell you about until
that's
the
true.
Time and date of the case. And that caused the judgment to be taken against you for the amount that you seek from her, which is bad for your credit. Your mother, Ms. Cobb, says your daughter should have known you didn't have money for the rent because you wound up losing your job, and you shouldn't have to pay just because you're her mother.
That's right.
And you give me the little head move.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. I've took care of her.
What's your tattoo say?
It's a butterfly.
Butterfly. Okay, you took care of her.
Yes.
You're 37, she's 20, and she's not your oldest, is she?
No, she's not.
Take care of your son, too?
Does she take care of my son?
No, you.
Yes, I do.
The oldest one?
No.
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 But it's her obligation to take care of her 14-year-old half-brother. So that's another reason why you shouldn't have to pay her. That's interesting. How about that boy's father, though?
How about him? I don't know.
Oh, little matter. Duty, responsibility, obligation, and accountability. All right. Now.
Well, Your Honor, back
your
in November of 2009, my mom did have her own place, but she did get evicted out of that one. And so...
Got evicted before.
Yeah. So she asked me to get a place in my name for her, because her credit was bad and she wasn't going to be able to get anything else in her name. So I did think about it, whether or not I should do it, because I don't know if she would pay the bills. But she had a job that she had been on for like over a year. And so, and time was winding down. Like, if I didn't do this for her, I feel like she wasn't going to have nowhere to stay.
Should have stayed with one of those boyfriends that seemed to have gotten a chance to lay up with her.
I got boyfriends. You don't know, Judge.
I'm looking at your circumstances. Is it or is it not the fact that your mother told you what you discovered to be the day that the first court setting had been entered?
Right, that's correct.
At about the time she was supposed to be in court?
Right.
And you didn't even show up for court, did you?
No.
No, you didn't. So you called your daughter, oh, girl, by the way, you got a case set today in small claims at 10 o'clock. I just thought I'd tell you about it. What?
Right.
How am I supposed to get from my job all the way down there, all of those miles in Kansas City downtown, and that's 10 minutes from now? What am I supposed
to
do?
Well, Judge, if she was going to pay it, then it would have been a different thing. Like,
if she's going to pay it,
right.
So that's how you teach your children?
No.
Forget what they say you do. You just do your thing. You know, don't pay it. I ain't paying it. I don't see why you have to. But you see, it's interesting. Your 20-year-old daughter had credit.
I did not say
didn't.
That. I did not say that.
You got evicted from the place immediately before that. So it wasn't bad enough that that's the kind of legacy and image and example you're setting for your kids.
Well, Judge, what you
we
don't
get
know,
trifling, so we get evicted.
Judge,
so,
Judge.
Okay, daughter's supposed to do the same thing, follow in my shoes, girl. Let me show you how it's done. You ain't got to take care of this, so your daughter can be broke, busted with a bunch of kids that can't be paid for.
Oh,
she's the one that has no kids at 20 trying to get a higher education and have a job and support you and her 14-year-old brother whose daddy won't even pay for her.
That I've took care of her very good.
That's your job.
I know that's my job.
So what's the problem here?
Well, right now...
We raise up the next generation so that when they get grown, they can be decent citizens, good citizens, productive citizens, uphold good character, ethics, and morality, and deal with making themselves, their families, something to be proud of, as well as the community that they live in, the city they live in, the state, and the country. Somewhere it's breaking down all to hell in this process, and it's going wrong. Look at you.
Look at me. What about it?
You
what
walk in it? Here like you a 15-year-old, 10th grade student. Mm-hmm. Your daughter is the one acting grown with more poise. Look, she knows how to stand up. She's demure, appropriately dressed.
Oh, my goodness.
You coming in looking like you getting ready to go to a party.
She knows what she's supposed to do because of me. I'm her mother.
You? She's supposed to go do this, sign a contract, break it on purpose, second one in a row, and dump it on somebody. It ain't my problem. Mm-mm. I had you. Took care of you. Mm-hmm. You can handle it for mama. I got to get my nails done, and I got to get my do done. Mm-hmm. I got some parties to go to. Can't be looking tacky. I need my money for something important.
Oh, Judge,
meanwhile,
I
you got this little
party.
Old 14-year-old brother down
know.
Here. You better help him out because I'm getting sick of him because he don't cop them attitudes. I'm tired of that. That's your brother, girl. That's your blood. You supposed to be helping him out. Well, if she's supposed to help that one out, you certainly are supposed to help this one out. Mm-hmm. But not only are you not helping this one out, you're harming this one. So, I mean, that's like being a cannibal. You know, I had you. I guess I can eat you on up. Now you a resource.
We'll be right back with Judge Joe Brown.
I raised her to be
And if
she
you
is.
Say that shows what the problem is, the way you're saying it.
The way I'm saying it.
Yeah. Like... See, most people, to have it right, is they come in here and talk about the sacrifice they made. They would not put this on the kid. They wouldn't even ask the kid to do what you did.
The defendant in this case says she took very good care of her daughter. She's taking lots of credit for raising a lovely young woman who she thought nothing of taking advantage of. Let's see what the judge has to say.
I know you.
Okay.
And I know what you call taking care of because in the 85 to 90,000 people I've dealt with in my career, I see it because
oh
it God. Repeats.
You don't even know me. You don't know what yeah, you're talking about. You don't know what you're talking
Listen
about.
Listen to it.
Don't.
By the way, I'm listening
I'm
to
mother.
You,
Look
but
at
I'm
her.
Watching
That's
you.
My child. I
understand.
This. I raised her to be
And
what
if
she
you
is.
Say that, shows what the problem is, the way you're saying it.
The way I'm saying it.
Yeah. Like, see, most people... To have it right is they come in here and talk about the sacrifice they made. They would not put this on the kid. They wouldn't even ask the kid to do what you did because, first off, they
okay,
would
well,
be too bloody embarrassed. And at 37 years old,
up,
when
done.
You're supposed
to...
Oh, you're
for?
Talking over me.
What am I standing here for if you already know you made your mind up?
I'm listening to you.
You
I read what
to
you
me.
Had, and then you opened your
okay.
mouth and you confirmed it.
Okay.
Well, let me put it to this. Mamas don't sit here and talk about, I got trifling.
Trifling?
So mama's supposed to make
trifling?
It... Yeah, trifling.
Who,
mama's
no,
supposed
not,
to make
trifling.
It good for children.
I'm
and what
I'm
mama... if you I'm walk good. Out of here, you aren't getting on that airplane. You got cab fare? I mean, you're trying to make it, and I really commend you on overcoming the example that you supposedly model yourself on. Thank you very much. You know, human communication is only 15% what you say, 35% the tone that you use when you say the words, and about 50% body language. And based on the 35% tone and the 50% body language, what your mother's problem is, she never saw or was exposed to what she needed to grow up and accept responsibility and understand obligation and accountability. That's not how adults do things. Leave your children better off than you were, and you do not cause them harm. You help them. She caused you harm. Now, in addition to everything else, There are some other damages.
Yeah, the light bill, because she had a bill of like over $3,000, so I had to get that in my name too.
I know, and you're stuck with the jurisdictional limit, $3,000. But you see, that's two causes of action. So you got stuck with the $2,660 on the rent. That's one cause. And this unpaid electric bill, which is quite a bit over $3,000, that's a separate cause of action. You're entitled to the jurisdictional limit on that, $3,000. So your total recovery, I hope it helps you out. We guarantee the collection of this, or get it for you one way or the other, will be $6,000.
Thank you, Your Honor.
And this courtroom is now in recess. Raising mama can be tough, and that's why we have Judge Show.
Her mother.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Joe takes on one mean mama.
Ain't my problem. Mm-mm.
You don't even know me.
A mother's sense of entitlement wreaks havoc on her daughter's pocketbook. Customer service rep Ebony Kearney is suing her mother for past due rent. Defendant Kimberly Cobb says the plaintiff should pay because she is her daughter. Now it's Joe time.
Ms. Kearney, you are suing your mother, Ms. Cobb, and your allegations are that she could not get her own apartment approved because of her credit problems, so you signed the lease for her.
Yes, that is correct.
You say she deliberately stopped paying the rent and stopped paying on the utility bill that you had also taken out for her in your name.
Yes, that's
leading
not true.
To an eviction proceeding, which she did not tell you about until
that's
the
true.
Time and date of the case. And that caused the judgment to be taken against you for the amount that you seek from her, which is bad for your credit. Mm-hmm. Your mother, Ms. Cobb, says your daughter should have known you didn't have money for the rent because you wound up losing your job, and you shouldn't have to pay just because you're her mother.
That's right.
And you give me the little head move.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. I've took care of her.
What's yeah. your tattoo say?
It's a butterfly.
Butterfly. Okay. You took care of her.
Yes.
You're 37. She's 20, and she's not your oldest, is she?
No, she's not.
Take care of your son, too?
Does she take care of my son?
No, you.
Yes, I do.
The oldest one?
No.
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 But it's her obligation to take care of her 14-year-old half-brother. So that's another reason why you shouldn't have to pay her. That's interesting. How about that boy's father, though?
How about him? I don't know.
Oh, little matter. Duty, responsibility, obligation, and accountability. All right. Now.
Well, Your Honor, back
your
in November of 2009, my mom did have her own place, but she did get evicted out of that one. And so...
Got evicted before.
Yeah. So she asked me to get a place in my name for her because her credit was bad and she wasn't going to be able to get anything else in her name. So I did think about it, whether or not I should do it because I don't know if she would pay the bills. But she had a job that she had been on for like over a year. And so, and time was winding down. Like, if I didn't do this for her, I feel like she wasn't going to have nowhere to stay.
Should have stayed with one of those boyfriends that seemed to have gotten a chance to lay up with her.
I got boyfriends. You don't know, Judge.
Well, I'm looking at your circumstances. Is it or is it not the fact that your mother told you what you discovered to be the day that the first court setting had been entered?
Right. That's correct,
Judge. At about the time she was supposed to be in court?
Right.
And you didn't even show up for court, did you?
No.
No, you didn't. So you called your daughter, oh, girl, by the way, you got a case set today in small claims at 10 o'clock. I just thought I'd tell you about it. What?
Right.
How am I supposed to get from my job all the way down there, all of those miles in Kansas City downtown, and that's 10 minutes from now? What am I supposed to
Judge,
do?
Well, Judge, if she was going to pay it, then it would have been a different thing. Like,
if she's going to pay it,
right.
So that's how you teach your children?
No.
Forget what they say you do. You just do your thing. You know, don't pay it. I ain't paying it. I don't see why you have to. But you see, it's interesting. Your 20-year-old daughter had credit.
I did not say that.
You got evicted from the place.